The first package I tried was WhisperJax. Simply copy the GitHub code snippet and change the output to your audio file without changing any chunking attributes, and with my old 16GB M1 Mac Mini, for a 10-minute long audio, it took me about 17 minutes. In the pipeline, you can set the return timestamp, set it to true, and it'll show the time of each subtitle. Of course, the timestamp format must be like the one I did with Faster Whisper in a subtitle format .srt before being embedded to the video. Basically, if you wanna use WhisperJax on Mac, simply go to its GitHub, follow the instruction to pip install, and then copy and paste the code, and it will run. But if you're like me, didn't set anything, then you might end up with slow transcription. Okay, let's go to Faster Whisper. Open terminal, point to the external SSD. Before that, I create the test Jupyter folder to host my Jupyter notebooks. Go to the terminal and point to the test Jupyter folder. Since my virtual environment is bound to this test Jupyter folder, inside the test Jupyter folder, activate the virtual environment. Enter Jupyter Lab. Here I made a notebook. On Faster Whisper's GitHub, copy the code you need. Before that, I put the mp3 file, which I need to output a Cantonese sub, to my test Jupyter folder. The mp3 file must be in the same folder with your script. Here, I changed the transcribed audio file to the one that I just uploaded. I tried outputting TikTok-like single word caption, but I failed the first time. Try it again and also fail. So I switched back to long format. Remember, each subtitle segment must be in a dictionary format. Then append to the blank list results. To transcribe this 50-second video, it took me 39 seconds. Let's see the end product of the sub. If you want to get single word sub in segment, add the word timestamp attribute. Then in the for loop results, change it like this. Shift enter, run it. For the 50-second video we transcribed before, it took me 45 seconds. When editing my video, I use that single word sub. Although it's quite accurate, the time is all shifted. For YouTube Shorts, these kind of videos still works, but do reserve time to manually fix the timestamps. That's it for the sharing. Ciao.